Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today is a very special episode because we are going to talk about a very special food, and today all over the world people call it as a superfood. That is nothing but these drumstick leaves. In Ayurveda they even call it as Brahma Vriksham because of its great medicinal value. And it has been known for a very long time in India, but around the world people are now recognizing its medical benefits and nutritional value, and the people are making tablets and capsules and powders and Moringa tea and so many other ways because they have now understood the nutritional benefit of this. The botanical name is Moringa oleifera, and this generally we use the drumstick, the vegetable, for making sambar. This is the leaf, and you can preferably use the tender leaves because they cook very fast. You bring it home and then wrap it in a kitchen towel like this and keep it for about a couple of hours, and then you will find that you are easily able to remove the leaves from the stalk. Or simply, it's not difficult, just remove the leaves like this from the stalk. Okay, these small stalks, whatever are remaining on this, because it is tender, you can allow it to remain in the sabji. We can use it, just remove it like this. This can be used in a wide variety of ways. We can make sambar, we can make kootu, we can use it in adai, we can use it in vadai. I'll show you many other preparations. This was not easy for me to get, whereas in Tamil Nadu, you will find nearly every house has a drumstick tree in their backyard. In fact, it is so very common that it was actually known as the poor man's food. People who could not afford to buy other vegetables, they used to survive on eating these drumstick leaves. It is very good for health. It increases your immunity. It also helps for people who suffer from constipation. We'll talk more about it. First, we have removed the leaves, throw away these major stalks, okay, or the stem. These tender stalks, if they are remaining, it's all right because the leaves are very tender. Use the fresh leaves, and if you find any yellow colored leaves, discolored leaves, throw them away. Next, take water in a vessel and wash the leaves thoroughly. Just swish it around like this. If you find any yellow leaf like this, discard it, don't use it. And wash the leaves, clean them thoroughly like this. See, whenever you clean any greens, it is best to put the leaves in plenty of water like this and then take out the leaves, the washed leaves. Today we are going to make a dal using these drumstick leaves, which can be eaten along with rice as well as served with rotis. So you can have rice and this drumstick leaf dal, or roti or chapati with drumstick leaf dal as a side dish. Apart from here, I have some split moong dal, the yellow moong dal. I have taken quarter cup and soaked it in water and kept. So when you are cooking it in an open pan, it is better to soak it as your cooking time will be reduced. It is always good to cook the drumstick leaves in an open pan and not in a pressure cooker or a closed vessel. So just heat a kadai. While this kadai is heating, I will tell you a little more. One of my earliest memories of this drumstick leaf is my mother, whenever she made ghee, that is the homemade butter, which then we are heating and clarifying it and making into ghee, she used to add a few drumstick leaves to it, and it would give a very good aroma and the ghee would stay good for several months. Now this is useful for, as I said, a number of things. One is it can control hair fall. It is very good for eyesight, so you can make a soup out of it and give to small children especially. It is good as a detox. It is good for killing intestinal worms. And also for people with blood pressure, it is said to help in reducing the blood pressure. For those with diabetes, for those who want to control their cholesterol levels, their fat levels, them, for them also this drumstick is a very good food. That's why we call it as a superfood. Now we'll just heat a tablespoon of oil. Drumstick leaves are very beneficial for young girls, especially during their periods when they suffer from menstrual cramps. It's very good to give them these drumstick leaves. Pregnant women can take drumstick leaves. It's very good for them. For those mothers after delivery, it increases their lactation, so they will have a good flow of breast milk. For them also these drumstick leaves are very good. I'm just adding a few mustard seeds to this. Next, added some cumin seeds. 2 or 3 green chilies. I have cut them big because if you cut them very small, when you have greens, it might accidentally come into your mouth. 1 large onion I have chopped and 2 or 3 cloves of garlic. Those of you who want to avoid onion and garlic, you can just proceed with the recipe without adding onion and garlic too. But you can notice that I have used only very little quantity of these because I don't want that taste to overpower the drumstick leaves. So stir fry these for a couple of minutes. Today we see many small children, school going children, even in class 2 or 3 who are wearing specs. Please give them these drumstick leaves at least twice or thrice a week. Those who are suffering from urinary problems also, drinking this drumstick leaf juice and carrot juice in the mornings really helps a lot. And also many people suffer from asthma. It's becoming very common nowadays, call it asthma or allergic bronchitis, cold, chest congestion. For them also this moringa leaves, drumstick leaves used in some form or the other is very good to improve their condition. For diabetics also it is good. So that is why it's called a superfood. Your hair, your heart, intestines, it kills the intestinal worms. Still got many more uses. I'll tell you as we go. Now to this, I'm going to add this moong dal. I had washed it earlier and then soaked. So I'm using the same water also along with it. Add a pinch of turmeric powder and allow it to cook till the dal is nearly done. See, the dal is more than 3/4 cooked. I have not made it very soft and mushy. I have just waited it like that. At this stage, we can add these washed drumstick leaves to this. Mix it well together. We can add a little more water to this. Add some salt. Since the leaves are tender, it will cook quite fast. And also a little bit of hing. Mix it very well. See, even when you have any wounds, there also the juice of these drumstick leaves mixed with the til oil and applied over the wounds help in healing the wounds fast. There are so many benefits. I want to tell you the maximum number which I remember so that whoever is suffering from any of these problems can get some relief. Those suffering from mouth ulcers, eat drumstick leaves. Those suffering from stomach ulcers, if you have joint pains, juice of this mixed in castor oil and applied on your joints will help you get relief from joint pains. It is very good for the heart also. It helps you to improve your immunity, makes you strong. And today we find that many young couples have the problem. People are especially males are finding the problem of low sperm count and impotency, childlessness becomes a major issue. For this, a simple remedy is take this moringa leaf powder, mix it with ghee, mix it with rice and have it every day for a 40-day period. And according to Ayurveda, this helps to improve the sperm count also. See, the drumstick leaf has also cooked well and it is boiling well with the dal. At this stage you can switch it off and transfer it into your serving bowl. Only two points you have to remember. See, I have switched it off and the heat is retained and it is still continuing to boil. For small children, if they are not able to digest it, then you just filter it and only give the extract. And one important thing to remember is, since it is a little difficult to digest, don't take it at night. Have these moringa leaves in the morning, in the daytime, either breakfast or lunch, but not for dinner. That is the only thing you have to remember. And then you can get the huge number of benefits of this superfood. And I'm really proud of our culture and tradition that we knew all these benefits. And we used to just add it to our adai and vadai and dosai, kootu, porchukolumbu, everything, and build our nutrition in that way. Do try out this recipe, share it with your family and friends. And we'll meet again in Geeta's Kitchen in another tasty traditional homestyle recipe. Thank you.